Hi, my name is Piotr, and I work here at Zmorph as a product expert. Today, I will show you, in a series of videos, why Zmorph is the best all-in-one 3D printer on the market, how easy it is to use it, what kind of materials it can process, and how it can change your desktop into a workshop. Along with the premiere of Zmorph Fab, we also worked on upgrading our dedicated software Voxelizer into 3.0 version. It comes now not only with more user-friendly UI, but also with fixed stability and performance. Let's see how it works. We will start with selecting proper setup for Zmorph Fab. So as first, select Zmorph Fab. Then choose the toolhead from the list. In this situation, it will be CNC milling toolhead. And after that, we can press start, since there are no additional options. Now, we are in the CNC milling workflow. First thing that we always have to do is to import the file that we want to work with. I will import the example file for this video. This workflow can operate on 3D models, as well as on 2D files like DXF paths. To import the file, press big button import model on the center of the workspace. Since this video will be dedicated to 2D operations, I will import the .xf file from my example files. After choosing the file, the vector paths will be imported on the software instantly. If you wish to import more files, you can use import button on the left bottom corner of the UI. After uploading the file, we can distinguish two main elements on the workspace. Yellow block is the stock, which is nothing else but the virtual representation of the material that we will process on our machine. And marked by the blue color is the loaded path. The stock can be set in two ways. The first default one is the relative stock. This is the option where the stock adapts to the loaded paths. I will go to the DXF arrangement and scale the path to show you how it works. As you can see, as I scale up the paths, the stock also expands. One of the parameters that we can set in this method is the side offset to add extra stock around the border paths. And of course the same thing will happen while I scale down the logo. Now, the second way. It's called fixed size box. In this method, we can fix dimensions of the stock. In most common way, we just set the size of the material that we have mounted on our CNC work table. I will set the size of sample plywood shipped in the box with the machine, which is 100 mm of width, 200 mm of length, and 6 mm of height. Now, I can manually scale up the path to match the material and my needs. Here in the scene mode, we can also set so-called local coordination system. This is nothing else than the spot where we will physically set the zero position of the toolhead before we start the work. In regular practice, we set the coordination system to left front top. And it will be set as shown on the video. Now we can move on to the next mode, settings. Do it by pressing next button. This is the settings mode. Here we can set the settings for 2D milling operations. Looking from the top of the settings column, first parameter to set is stock material. In this parameter, we set what kind of material we have mounted on our CNC work table. We can either choose from the wide range of the presets materials or add our own by clicking on See More button on the bottom of the list. Here, we can duplicate the existing preset or add new one by using Add New Preset button. We can name the preset and set our own parameters. Then, we can go back to the settings and select the new preset on the list. But, in this example, I will go with Wood preset, as I'm planning to mill in the plywood. Next parameter is a toggle option that show or hide the outline of the stock material. Turning it on might help us with visualizing what is going to happen during the milling operations. Next one is a safe elevation. It tells the toolhead how much it have to rise for jog operations to make sure it won't hit anything on the workspace during the movement. I will leave it a default setting for safety. First milling operation is face milling. This operation allows us to prepare raw stock surface for machining. This operation removes material from the top surface of the stock to the top of the model to remove the roughness. First, I choose the operation. Then I select the face contour. In this example, it will be the stock. And we press continue. New settings will appear. We will leave starting height as it is. We'll change the final depth offset to -2 mm. Turning on show heights option will show us where the operation will start and where will it end. After that, we have to select the end mill that we'll use for this operation. After selecting it, the software will show us some more parameters that we can set. But for this example, we'll stay with the default ones. When everything is set, simply press apply. Now the operation will appear on the operation list. We can add another operation by clicking add new operation button. This time we will choose contour operation. As first thing, we have to choose contour to cut. Press select and press on the contours of the loaded paths, 3 in total. Then press done and continue. We will leave the starting height and change the final depth. Choose top of the stock and change the offset to -2 mm and press continue. Now choose the operation tool. I will select 2 mm flat end mill since this is the one that is shipped in the box with the machine. After selecting it, the software will generate the toolpath for us. As you can see, the contour operation will only cut the contour of the shapes and leave the inside. One of the parameters that features this contour operation is the contour size. You can choose if the end mill will mill outside the contours or inside them. Each setting will give us different results. Press apply to confirm the operation. Let's add next operation, pocket this time. This operation will allow us to remove the inside of the contours. As a pocket to cut, we select the whole area. Select the 3 spots and press done and then continue. Leave the starting height alone. In final depth, select top of the stock and set the offset to -3 mm this time. Press continue. Select the operation tool 2 mm flat end mill. Add toolpath and new parameters will appear. Now let's take a look on the toolpath. As we can see, the mill will take 3 steps to remove the 3 mm of the material. So each step will remove 1 mm of the material in height. Parameter that defines it is so-called max step down and can be found here. Let's change it into 2 mm and see what happens. Now we will have 2 steps, one with 2 mm and the last one with 1 mm, to make 3 mm in total. Press apply to confirm and let's move on to the last 2D milling operation. So let's press add next operation and select engrave. This operation might look like the same as contour, but its purpose is much different. As for the operations before, we should use cylindrical end mills, but for this one, it is recommended to use V-shaped ones. We use this operation to just square the surface of the material, like for example to engrave the name or engrave the whole electrical circuit on PCB. Select the contours to engrave and press done and then continue. As always, we'll leave the starting height as default and try the final depth as top of the stock with -1 mm offset. Our operation tool will be 45 degree engraving mill. Here we have much less options than in operations before, due to the fact that they are not needed. Let's apply the operation. Now we have 4 operations and we can look at every each of them by clicking on them. Let's remove the face milling by selecting it and clicking on the bin icon. Do the same with the contour and engrave. Let's just leave the pocket operation. At this point, we can also perform a simulation to see how the operation will look like. Press the simulation button. Pressing the play button will animate the milling for us. Simulations are most useful before performing more complex millings. Now we can press next to generate the G-code for this operation. All is left is to press the save button and put the file on the SD card to take it to the printer.